Здравейте, скъпи телевизионни зрители! Вие сте с предаването Фолклорна трапеза, аз съм Каролина Дичева. В последната седмица на месец май ще ви изненадаме приятно с музика, песни, танци и рецепти от далечна Индонезия. В днешния виртуален свят това не е невъзможна мисия, затова екипът ни се постара да осъществи контакт с днешните ни участници, които се намират на хиляди километри от нас. Те ще готвят народна земя с местни продукти и ще ни покажат едни от най-характерните рецепти за региона. Фолклорните изпълнения, които ще видите, са от фонда на студиото ни с записи от неколкократните участия на съставите от Джакарта в световния шампионат по фолклор, провеждан под егидата на Европейската асоциация на фолклорните фестивали ЕАВ в България. И така, нека да видим и чуем сега едно от тези изпълнения. Представям ви фолклорна група Гентари Гита като Листива с ръководител Лео Мокудумпит. Съставът стана носител на гран-при от световния шампионат по фолклор и абсолютен световен шампион по фолклор през 2014. Ето как изглеждат традиционните автентични танци от западна провинция Сумарета.
Thank you.
След всичко, което видяхте до тук, вероятно сте останали без дъх, но трябва да ви предупредя, че това беше само началото. Ще има още подобни изпълнения днес, но сега следва първата рецепта, която може да проследите единствено тук, в фолклорна трапеза. Рецептата е на традиционна салата с фъстъчен сос и, разбира се, е от далечна Индонезия. Наименованието на салатата е гадо-гадо. Ще я приготвят Лео Мокодумпит и Галан Клестари, които в момента се намират в Западна Ява, Индонезия. Преди рецептата ще видим кратко интервю с Лео Мокодумпит, който ще сподели с нас спомени от пребиваването си в България.
I remember I've been, if I'm not mistaken, 4 times to Bulgaria, and each visit is just like coming to my second home. You know, Bulgarians are very warm and nice people, and then the, you know, the nature itself is beautiful, and the culture itself is really rich. I mean, if you see how the Bulgarian traditional dance, the Bulgarian traditional music, it's all really enjoyable to, you know, to witness, to see, to enjoy. So it's really a pleasure for us, not only me, but also all team of Gandhari Kita Katulistiwa in Indonesia. We have several chances to visit Bulgaria. Hopefully, after this pandemic, we will have another chance to visit Bulgaria. I remember, so, well, actually during Elstay, because our group most likely we stay in Burgas and, you know, in Nesebar also. It's like a very touristic place. But I remember the place where we stay, they serve us a typical Bulgarian traditional dishes. The first one, it was a sopska salad with cucumbers on it. It's very delicious. It's really good. And the other one is a cold soup. We call it tarato. It's also very delicious. So our team, every time the hotel serves that food for us, like maybe in 5 minutes, then all the food are disappeared. So, you know, it's just like our best food that we remember about Bulgaria, and it's really delicious. Very recommended. Thank you very much for inviting us on behalf of Gandhari Kita Katulistiwa. It's really nice to still can share through online what we have here in Indonesia. Like during the pandemic, even we did our practice on our traditional dance and music back in our studio using, you know, online platform. So our students are learning the dances and music from home, only using this, you know, video conference. But still, that's one of the way that we want to show the world that we're not giving up on this pandemic. I mean, this pandemic will not stopping us to still practicing, to still preserving our culture. In any way, there's still a way to, you know, to still running the activities. And hopefully, the pandemic is going to be over soon. Then we can meet up each other again, maybe in Bulgaria. We are now also still preparing ourselves to participating at one of the online festival hosted by the EAFF as well. So hopefully next time we can just visit each other. Maybe next time we can visit your country, yeah, our so two dishes.
We'll present you two menus, like in Indonesian, we usually have in our, as our main dishes. First time is gado-gado and second is soto ayam.
Yes. So gado-gado mainly is kind of salad, vegetable salad. So mixed vegetable salad with peanut sauce. As they, you know, usually if in the Western countries or abroad, you use what the sauce usually for the peanut salad?
Yeah, kind of mayonnaise.
You use mayonnaise or maybe olive oil, but here in Indonesia,
we have the peanut sauce. Yes. With some of spices.
Yes, exactly. So let's prepare for our first dish. It's going to be gado-gado or Indonesian traditional salad. What is different is that usually salad are served for the appetizer. But here in Indonesia, this kind of salad, that's why we don't call it salad, because it's an entree. It's a main dishes, main course. You know, we eat it as like a heavy food. So, Ilan, yes, you can start now.
Hi, so this is the menu, so this is the ingredients to make the gado-gado. First, we need water spinach. I have boiled all the vegetables already, and this is the long beans and cabbage, and this one
coyote,
and this is, we call it tempeh. But I have, we will use the fried one. Actually, the original one looks like this.
This is the raw version of tempeh. It made from the soybeans.
And fermented soybeans.
Fermented, and it becomes like this. It's very rich nutrition with protein from, you know, and this one.
So
is,
I cut the tempeh into dices and then just fried it.
Now, how to make gado-gado? What we have to prepare?
Yeah, for the peanut sauce, of course, we need some peanuts, 1 clove of garlic, and then there's chilies and the palm sugar, and also salt, of course. So we put the in Indonesia, we use like this kind of traditional blender. Maybe
this is a very traditional one in Indonesia. If you want to mix something, we use this, how we call it, it's like something made from the stone. It's like a blender, but it's like
a very traditional one
made from the stone that they get from the top of the mountain. So before
so
they
blend the peanut.
The peanut is already fried as well.
Then the peanut, and then the 1 clove of garlic.
Garlic.
And then
chili.
Yeah, chili. You can use the chili as many as you want.
If you like it spicy, you add more chili on it. But if you want to make it just a little spicy, so the chili could be depend on, you know, your taste. What is your taste?
And salt.
And the salt. So peanut, chili, brown sugar, salt, and garlic. We blend it together using the traditional. It's like this. You know.
You can use the modern one. You can use the modern blender.
This is a very traditional. All households in Indonesia have this because, you know, when you do this, the taste is going to be out even more from the peanuts itself, from the coconut sugar or the brown sugar and the chili. So you did it and make it like until it's really
until it blends together,
blends.
It's getting soft. And I have
the final
version. So this is the final result. After you blend all the peanuts and also the spices, you add some more warm water and into this kind of salt. So this is the final one, the final result.
Yes. Now we have already the peanut sauce for the gado-gado. What is next, Gila?
So we will mix this sauce with the vegetables. Okay, first we can put the water spinach. And then
coyote. Cabbage. All these vegetables already steamed or can be boiled as well. So make the texture of the vegetables a little softer than the raw one. Okay, that's how it looks before all vegetables and also the fried tempeh. This is one of the most important ingredients of the gado-gado. Okay, so you mix it on the plate like this. And then, usually in Indonesia, so after you put all of these vegetables on the plate, you pour the peanut sauce at the top. Yes. And then don't forget.
You can add some condiments, the
boiled egg.
And then we have fried shallot. This is the fried shallot. In Indonesia, usually add fresh shallot to all our dishes.
At the top, it will make the gado-gado even smells really, really good.
And of course, Indonesian always love crackers.
Yes. This is shrimp crackers.
Some crackers.
Put some crackers on it. All right. So.
Here it is.
Gado-gado. This is our first dishes, gado-gado. So it looks like this with the peanut sauce, vegetables. In Indonesia, because this is the main dish, it's not a side dish. So people eat it usually with rice cake or even rice itself. So during lunchtime or dinner, this is typical Indonesian gado-gado. And what is important is in Indonesia, there are 34 provinces. And in some provinces, they have their own version. So this is the national version of gado-gado. But if you fly or you travel to another province, sometimes they have a specific kind of gado-gado, a little bit adjustment in the gado-gado, and they call it in different way. But like the appearance is exactly like this, right? Like if you travel to West Java, they usually not boil or steam the vegetables.
Yeah.
They'll just cut it raw. They serve it with the peanut sauce, but the peanut sauce, they add some more ingredients
some
spices, yes. And they not call it gado-gado. They call it
karedo.
And also you fly to another province again, they have such kind of similar thing with gado-gado, and they call it different way, and they add some more ingredients and spices and stuff. But this is the national version of gado-gado.
След това впечатляващо видео, сега следва да ви зарадваме с още едно танцово изпълнение на наши добри приятели от Индонезия. Следва да видим индонезийски танци от провинция Папуа, от репертуара на фолклорен ансамбъл Кенцана Прадила към Университет Индонезия, град Депок, Индонезия, с художествен ръководител Дони Юшинда, който стана носител на Гран-при и титлата Абсолютен световен шампион по фолклор за 2017 от участието си в 7-я световен шампионат по фолклор. Thank you. скъпи телевизионни приятели, след тази изключително силна танцова композиция, сега отново бъдете готови да проследите приготвянето на още едно от емблематичните за Индонезия ястия – сото аям. Това е традиционна пилешка супа. Любопитството в мен надделява, така че нека да видим и следващото видео заедно.
Now, let's try our second menu for today. We have already the gado-gado here. Now, we're going to make soto ayam or chicken soup, Indonesian chicken soup.
Actually, the soto ayam is not like, I made a clear one because like Leo said, like there were 34 provinces in Indonesia, so each province have their own way to make soto ayam. So this one, I made a very national one, the original soto ayam. And I make the clear one because sometimes some people make with coconut milk, so it's a little bit
heavy, like heavy or one. Like, yeah. You know?
So to make soto ayam, first we should pick the
basic spices
that we need. So this is the ingredients to make the basic spices is shallot, garlic,
lemongrass,
and then this is the lime leaves
here. If you try
lemongrass.
Smells really good. Chili as a condiment.
And then this is what we need for the papaya, the cabbage. I boiled it already. And then the rice vermicelli. And our, of course, the chicken. I shred it. I boiled and shred it. So to make the spices, I blend all the shallot, garlic, and also this one, turmeric. I use the powder one. I blend it all together, and then I salt it all with a little bit of oil, and I salt it. And after we salted all the spices, we put all the spices into the boiled water.
Maybe, yes, a little bit, and show how the chicken soup works.
Yeah, so here it is, the soup. After I put all the ingredients, I mean all the spices, so put it in boiled water. You can add some chicken stock also to make it a little bit very flavor. So I will prepare for the soto. First, put the rice vermicelli.
Or maybe normally you say it as noodle glass, but noodle this glass. One, yes. Glass noodle, I mean, sorry. Glass noodles, you pour it in a bowl, and then
add the cabbage,
the one that's already steamed or boiled, right? And then you put the chicken, which already shredded. Yes. And here's the soup. Later on, it'll be poured on the bowl.
So just pour the water into the.
Yes, that's the soup.
And of course, don't forget, Indonesian dishes will always have some condiments.
The boiled egg.
Fried shallot. Scallion.
Scallion. Tomatoes.
Tomatoes. Before you eat, you can pour some
lime
juice. Yes. And of course, serve with the crackers.
Crackers.
If you love spicy food, you can add some more sambal.
Sambal or chili flakes.
Or chili flakes.
Yes. So, our friends, these are two typical Indonesian dishes that usually prepared in Indonesian households. This one is gado-gado or vegetable salad, vegetable mixed salads, Indonesian vegetable mixed salads, and also soto. This is what it looks like for the gado-gado, and this is what it looks like for the soto. Yes. Okay, maybe you can just have a little focus on this food, maybe. Yes. So I can show how it looks from the close. There you go, gado-gado and soto ayam.
Със сигурност сте останали впечатлени от всичко, което се случи днес в фолклорна трапеза. Благодарим на Лео Мокодумпит и Галан Клестари за рецептите, както и на Салма Захра, отговорник на място, за видеозаснемането. Сега следва да завършим с танца Саман, един от най-атрактивните заради бързината и координацията между танцорите танци. Гледайте ни отново и следващата седмица, когато кулинарното ни пътешествие ще продължи. За днес от мен, довиждане!
Damai.